Wash your ass. Guys, ladies, gentlemen, you have to maintain high personal levels of cleanliness. Personal hygiene is paramount to your mental and physical health. It's paramount, guys. You have to take care of yourself. Your environment, your car. I mean, you have to take care of yourself. You know what I'm saying? I mean, just think about it. If you lived on a dirty street where it's trash everywhere, you live in a dirty house where there's trash everywhere, your car is dirty, there's trash everywhere, your mind is dirty, there's trash everywhere, that's a sign of mental illness. Like, one thing that sets America apart from a lot of countries is our level of hygiene. We are pretty much at the top. You know why though? But it's because of a collective effort. Everybody took part in raising the awareness level of personal hygiene. So real fast, I'm gonna just go over some categories of personal hygiene where you need to make sure that you're doing this, you know, on a daily or bi-daily a basis, you know, depending on your job. You know, everybody don't have access to a bathroom or a shower every day. But that's okay. But you need to be conscious of your brushing your teeth, washing your face, all those things. So let me start. Hair care. Washing and grooming your hair regularly can prevent dandruff, lice, scalp infections. Children should wash their hair 1 to 2 times a week or more often if it's oily. Nail hygiene. Keeping your nails short and clean can reduce the risk of infection caused by dirt and germs getting trapped underneath. Brushing and flossing your teeth. Brushing teeth remove food particles and bacteria, while flossing removes food particles from between teeth. Irregular brushing and flossing can lead to cavities, bleeding gums, and bacterial growth. It's also recommended to see a dentist at least twice a year for cleaning and exam. Bathing. Children should have a regular bath or shower, which can be part of their bedtime routine. Washing clothes. Wash clothes with detergent and dry them immediately. Cover your mouth when you cough or sneeze. Guys, that shit is too basic for a grown-ass man or woman to be walking around here coughing and sneezing without covering the mouth. That should really be a crime. Like, you should really go to jail for doing that shit. It's nasty. That shit is nasty. You're spreading viruses and you're spreading germs. You're a piece of crap if you're doing that. Getting enough sleep. Adults should get 7 to 9 hours sleep per night. I get about 6. Creating a routine. Make a checklist or write down a routine to help you maintain good hygiene habits. Visiting the doctor. Maintain regular healthcare appointments. Practicing good hygiene can help prevent illness, reduce the risk of infection, and improve physical and mental well-being. Hold on 1 second, guys. Okay, guys, so let me give you an example of poor sanitary habits. Open defecation. Many of you guys have probably never heard of that term before, but it is a very common problem in underdeveloped countries and third world countries and even second world countries. Open defecation, or defecating in open spaces without proper disposal of human waste, can have many negative effects on public health and society. Open defecation can contaminate drinking water sources and spread diseases like chlorella, diarrhea, and listeria. It can also transmit pathogens that cause diarrheal diseases, which are the second leading cause of death globally. Other diseases that can spread through open defecation include intestinal worms, and those other two words, I don't even know how to pronounce them, I'm sorry. Child mortality. poor hygiene practices and fecal contamination of environment can lead to child mortality, malnutrition, and stunting growth. Open defecation can also negatively impact cognitive development. Countries with widespread open defecation also tend to have higher levels of poverty, malnutrition, and wealth disparity. Gender. Women and girls who defecate in the open are more vulnerable to violence and sexual exploitation. They may also be less likely to attend school, which can limit their future opportunities. Open defecation can also pose safety risks, such as fear of accessing shared or public toilets at night, or the risk of falling into an open drop hole. Oh my God. See, man, see, guys, see, in America, you all have to realize, like, we are at the very top as far as our opportunities are. Not intellectually wise, because we got with some idiots, a lot of idiots in America. But as far as opportunity, as far as freedom, as far as amenities, as far as luxury goods, like there are a lot of regular things that we can get from Dollar Tree that's a luxury in other countries. So we take a lot for granted in this country, but we are at the very top as far as those things I just mentioned, except for intellect. Like we're not the most intelligent people in this country. We got a lot of sick psychopaths in this country. Just like I was sharing with you yesterday, how 10 million animals are murdered every day. I mean, are murdered every year. Now, I'm not talking about euthanized. I'm talking about murder in somebody's home. Killed in somebody's home, abused and killed in somebody's home. 10 million. That shows you how many psychopaths that are under the radar in this country. And these are regular psychopaths. These are not like Ted Bundy type psychopaths. You know, these are not like, what's the other guy's name? I cannot remember the other guy's name. Anyway, it's not your textbook psychopath. These type of psychopaths are the ones who abuse children and animals. These are teachers. These are doctors. These are nurses. These are athletes, all kind of people across all walks of life, all ages, all races, both genders and transgenders, all of them. The sweet little old lady that's so cute. This woman is abusing 9 cats at home, 2 birds and a goldfish. She's abusing everybody because she's a hoarder. She has mental illness because of all the medication that she's taking. And she don't understand what she's doing is abusive. So it's a lot of sick people in this country. Anyway, let me continue. Open defecation not only affects land, water, and air, but also plants and animals. Air pollution also takes place when these odors escape into the atmosphere. People then get affected and suffer when they inhale this. The nature of the soil is also affected when this waste is discharged directly into the ground. And the problem is not with... The problem, guys, is not with the fecal matter itself. It's not with the poop itself. The problem is with the poop that's contaminated, with the toxins and the crap that we eat. So if we ate cleaner foods, the defecation wouldn't affect the environment. Just like animals defecate, birds defecate, dogs defecate, every species, every animal defecate. And they don't defecate in a toilet. Fish defecate, bird, everybody. Human defecation is a problem because of the poisons that we eat. That's the problem. The chemicals that we eat, that is the problem. It's not the fecal matter. It's not the waste. That's the word. It's not the waste itself. That's the problem. If we ate clean and green, you could probably use the bathroom anyway. It still wouldn't be. The most cleanest thing to do is still would be, I would still advocate, regular toilet use. But the point I'm trying to make is our waste is toxic because our food is toxic. Have you ever been to the bathroom after somebody and it smells like a dead body? That's because the inside of their body is dead. That's why that is. Your poop is not supposed to smell like that. But it does. I mean, horrible. Because of all the medication, all of the chemicals, all of the toxins and pesticides that we eat. When we poop, when animals poop, it's fertilizer. When we poop, it's poison. Let me say that again. When animals poop, we use chicken poop, cow manure, horse manure as fertilizer, because it's fertilizer for the vegetation, for the earth. Even when an animal dies, that animal's body is not poison or toxic. It goes back to fertilize the earth. When an animal dies, it fertilizes the earth. It goes back to the earth. They don't get buried inside of a tomb. Even trees, defecate by dropping their leaves. And that's how they release their waste. So you have to understand, guys, we are toxic people. We are poisoned. So back to personal hygiene, like where I started. That's why personal hygiene is so important. Because it promotes an environment of cleanliness all the way around for children and adults. Well, we have so many mentally ill adults in this country that's raising children that's going to be mentally ill that this society will collapse. It's just a matter of time. It may be another 50 or 100 years, but it will collapse. It's going to go to a third world. It's going to go to a third world. Because we're going to run out of qualified intellects in this country. They're all dying right now. And the only people that's going to be left are the psychopaths. So guys, get ready for the patience to take over pretty soon. Have a nice day.